Quiero estar cerca de ti.
Music is a big part of my family. My dad was a percussionist, and my mom is an angel, and she sings like an angel. I grew up with congas in our living room. My dad used to have these things called rumbas, and we would stay up until 11 o'clock on school nights, 12 in the morning, and just listen to music. My brother and I would come in there and grab pans and play the congas. I grew up in South Bronx, New York. My family and I were poor, material-wise, but we were rich in that we had each other. There came a really rough time with us with my dad. When he was 19, he went to Vietnam, and that really affected him. For years, he struggled with drug addiction. And when I was 13 years old, I actually watched him become a heroin addict. And that was really tough for our family. My mom, however, she is the rock of our family, and she would take us to church and really, really instill in us faith. And at the same time, she told us, never give up on your dreams. Needless to say, I had made decisions, very poor decisions, at a very young age. I dropped out of high school and lived on the streets for a while. But still, that hope that my mom instilled in us early on still rang true, and there was not a day that went by where I thought of that. There was a turning point. So I had an opportunity. My aunt from Puerto Rico said, hey, I've learned of your story. I want to give you an opportunity. We have a place. We want you to come to Puerto Rico and finish school. And I finished high school, and I also proceeded to go to college and worked really, really hard. I was focused now to get my life back in this place where it was solid. When I was in college, the last year, I got an opportunity to travel with a group called Jaque Mate, and it was a great opportunity for me. We toured all over Latin America. We opened up for Ricky Martin and for Maná. Maná was actually just starting, and then we went on to be nominated for a Grammy Award. Since that time, the purpose for doing music has changed. We now do projects more focused on inspiring people. We just completed a project as a tribute to my dad and the legacy of his music and my mom, called Amor, which is love in Spanish. And it's a very, very special and dear project in my heart. It really speaks to my family, and it speaks to the hope that we've been given and just how there's so much restoration when you come together and look up. I feel when you've been blessed tremendously, today I have a beautiful family, my wife Martha, my sons Joshua and Christian, and my daughter Sophia Grace. I feel that we've been blessed immensely. All those blessings, we feel now that we've been given those to be able to pay it forward. This year, we'll give away a scholarship with a nonprofit that we have called Don't Give Up. It's very close to my heart because it helps inner city kids achieve their dreams, and it's very much my story.